ISUPK.
Yeah, it's your boy Lola, let you know what's up when we rolling up, man. Hey, man, real quick, man, handsome, check it out. You got to tune in, man. The brother Tazariok is doing some mean things. Big shout out to ISUBK, man. Mean, man, you got to get that work. You got to go to the platform and get that work. You're giving it up, you hear me?
Your icon.
When me wrote them, they bring him.
Yeah,
kill him, kill him.
Hanging tree. Body boy, rape a boy, now got dead pussy.
Inna the blood clot place me from. And you only no support no rape a man, no. Some boy a must see body man. How the fuck them a murder so much woman, no.
No rape we no support.
Them pussy they no figure face, no judge in a no call.
I mean if them a got in a your church, chop him up fine and national ball.
When the last them, the gas them, the tire. Jungle justice, the machine on fire. Run him down, witness the attic, go catch him. Pussy love kidnap, girl, alright, kidnap him. Everybody in the community chop him. Big out in the eye them, toenail, mad him. To the police now grab him. Every girl we walk on the pass, just stab him.
Yeah, the world today, they need to know. Love the youths and let them grow.
Rape a fi dead, who no kill him. Rape a fi dead, who no kill him.
The world today, they need to know.
Shalom Israel, shalom Yahweh Bashimi and Shabrak, Satan and brothers. To my sisters, Shalom Yahweh Shamar El, a son, Bahashimi Awashai. I'm Officer Galavan from Trinidad and Tobago, from the Israelite School of the Universal Practical Knowledge under Commanding General Yohana. From since 1969, this school has been teaching that black people are the lost 12 tribes of Israel. Right? There's a collusion that has been going on in the Christian church that has been teaching black people lies, lies upon lies, a collusion, which is that God loves all the races on the face of the earth. But according to the scripture, God does not love all the races on the face of the earth. According to the scriptures, God only loves one particular race of people, right? And that's black people, right? So today I'm going to break down John 3:16, right? The famous scripture that the Christians pull to show that God loves all the races of people, right? So let me start by John 3:16. John chapter 3 verse 16. For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believeth in him should not perish, but have everlasting life. So the scriptures pull this and say the word world means the whole planet or all races of people. Well, first things first, two black brothers were speaking here with each other. Nicodemus, who was a Jew, and Christ, who was a Jew. It was two black brothers having a conversation amongst themselves, right? And the word world is a Greek word, which means age or society. It means cosmos in Greek. It means age or society, right? Or divisions of mankind. So, I'm going to prove it in the scriptures. I'm going to start with Psalms chapter 90, verse 2. All right? This is Psalms chapter 90, verse 2. Before the mountains were brought forth, however, thou hast formed the earth and the world, even from everlasting to everlasting, thou art God. So this scripture here is telling you that it has a difference between the earth and the world. So then what is this world, right, that Christ was speaking about in John 3:16? Right? Let's get Hebrews chapter 11, verse 3. Right? Through faith we understand that the worlds were framed by the word of God, right? No, they said the worlds were framed by the word of God. Let me spell that for you. W-O-R-L-D-S. Worlds, which is more than one, plural. It's more than one. So if it has more than one world on this face of the earth, then what was John 3:16 talking about? What is that world, that one world, that Christ was speaking about in John 3:16? Because here in Hebrews 11 verse 3, it says it has worlds, right? The worlds were framed through the word of God, which means more than one. So it has more than one world on the face of the earth. It has the Chinese world, right? It has the East Indian world, which is the Hindu community. It has black people world who live in down here in Trinidad, in Lavanter or John, Beetham, right? That is our world. It has the white man's world. It has the Syrian community world, this year, this Sabbath, I was seeing that 1% of the Syrians in Trinidad, just 1%, and they're a minority, and they control Trinidad. That's their world. They control Trinidad, right? So it has different worlds, different society, different divisions of mankind on the face of the earth. Trinidad itself is called a third world, right? England, those other countries, is considered first world. Because why? We move different, a different society, different people, right? We move different, act different, right? That's what I'm talking about. So it has different worlds on the face of the earth, right? So let's get 1 John chapter 2, verse 15, right? So this is 1 John chapter 2, verse 15. It says, love not the world, neither the things that are in the world. So if John 3:16, Christ is saying, for God so loved the world, and then in 1 John chapter 2, verse 15, it says, love not the world. But then we get to understand that in Hebrews 11 and 3, it has different worlds on the face of the earth. So then, what is the world in John 3:16 that Christ was speaking about? And what is this world that it says, love not the world, you know, the things that are in the world? Well, I'm going to tell you something. This world here, in 1 John chapter 2, verse 15, when it says, love not the world, it's talking about the white man's world. In the white man's world, it could be a homosexual. In the white man's world, it could be a child molester. In the white man's world, it could sell drugs. In the white man's world, you can be a rapist. In the white man's world, you can hate your brother and love your oppressor. In the white man's world, they're opening up. They're trying to pass the law for pedophilia. It's called the North American Man-Boy Love Association. They're trying to pass the rights for an adult person to have sex with a two-year-old child. Right? They're trying to pass the law so that the age of consent could be abolished. So that means what? If I'm 56 years old, I can have sex with a two-year-old child. That's what's going on in the white man's world right now. So that's why they said, love not the world, neither the things that are in the world. Right? So what Christ was speaking about now, for God so loved the world. So let's get to find out now. Let's go to Isaiah chapter 45. Verse 17. Alright. Isaiah chapter 45, verse 17. But Israel shall be saved in the Lord. It says, but Israel. It didn't say the Chinese shall be saved in the Lord. It didn't say the white man shall be saved in the Lord. It didn't say the Africans shall be saved in the Lord. It didn't say the East Indians, which is the Hindu community, shall be saved in the Lord. It then says the Arabs shall be saved in the Lord, which is the Muslim community. It then says that. It says Israel. And the Israelites, according to the scriptures, are black people. Blacks, Hispanics, and native Indians are the lost 12 tribes of Israel. That one race of people, Israel. Right? So it says, but Israel shall be saved in the Lord with an everlasting salvation. So I'm going to be saved. My brothers in Bitum Guam be saved. My brothers in Lavantil Guam be saved. My sisters in Mova is going to be saved. Black people all around who were scattered throughout during slavery. The native Indians who the white man brainwashed them, think they forget who they were. The Hispanics who they enslaved, which is the Puerto Ricans, right? The Cubans, we are going to be saved. The lost 12 tribes of Israel who were scattered about on the earth during slavery, right? We are the ones who's going to be saved. So it says, but Israel shall be saved in the Lord with an everlasting salvation. Ye shall not be ashamed. Meaning when I say we shall not be ashamed, there's going to be a point in time when we ain't going to be ashamed to be Israelites. We're going to stop follow Christianity to be like the white man. We're going to stop follow Islam to be like them Arabs and them. We're going to stop follow Kemet to be like them stinking Africans and them. We're going to stop follow Hinduism to be like them East Indians and them. We ain't going to be ashamed no more. We're going to walk away from Hinduism. We're going to walk away from Islam, walk away from Christianity, walk away from Kemet and say, yes, I am an Israelite. I ain't no stinking African. Let them have the culture and let them come back to the Israel, to the law, statutes and commandments of the Most High. It says, ye shall not be ashamed or confounded. You won't be confused no more. You won't be confused no more. Nor confounded world without end. The scripture here says that we are the world without end. So in this John chapter 3, verse 16, that world that Christ was speaking about was the Israelites. The Israelites are the world without end. We won't be ashamed nor confounded anymore. We won't be confused no more. We will know who we are. And we will admire who we are and come back to the laws, statutes, and commandments. Right? Now, they were talking about the whosoever. Right? In John chapter 3, verse 16, it says, whosoever. Right? So, let's break that down. In Acts chapter 2. Acts chapter 2 from verse 21. Right? And it shall come to pass that whosoever shall call on the name of the Lord shall be saved. Alright? So in John chapter 3 verse 16 it says, whosoever believeth shall be saved. So in Acts chapter 2 it says, and it shall come to pass that whosoever shall call on the name of the Lord shall be saved. Alright? So this scripture is something like, it's talking about all races. But no. Who was they talking to? Ye men of Israel. Right? It was talking to the men of Israel. It wasn't talking to the Chinese. It wasn't talking to the East Indians. It wasn't talking to the white people. It was speaking to the men of Israel. So it says, ye men of Israel, hear these words. So when they're talking about that, whosoever, they're talking about the Israelites. That is why it says, ye men of Israel, hear these words. Alright? Shalom, Yahweh, Shima, and Shabbatha. I'm Officer Galwan from Trinidad and Tobago.
Your icon. When me wrote them, they bring him. Yeah, no. Kill him, kill him. Hanging tree. Body boy, rape a boy, and I got dead pussy. In a day, blood clot, place me from. And you only not support a rape a man, no. Some boy, you must be body man. How the fuck them a murder so much, man, no. No raper, we no support. Them pussy, they no figure face, no judge in a no call. I mean, knife them, I got in a your charge. Chop him up, fine and national ball.
When the last them, the gas them, the tire. Jungle justice, the machine on fire. Run him down, wait, let's the hatching, go catch him. Pussy love, kidnap, gal, I